Hi, this is Murli from Naresh Technologies. Today we are going to discuss SQL Loader tool. It's the most powerful performance tool which is used to transfer data from flat file into Oracle database.
SQL Loader or SQL Star Loader.
What is the purpose of this SQL Loader tool?
Some data is there in a flat files, anywhere in a C colon, D colon or anywhere.
Now this is a database, Oracle database. Here in this Oracle database, some tables are available.
If you want to transfer this data from flat file into this Oracle database, then we are using SQL Loader is a tool.
But unfortunately, whenever SQL Loader tool is available, then flat file is available and the database is available, then directly we are unable to transfer data from flat file into Oracle database. This SQL Loader tool, this is a exe file, utility program, always executes a special type of file, control file. That's why based on the type of flat file, we are creating a control file and submit that control file into SQL Loader tool. Then only SQL Loader transfer data from flat file into Oracle database. That's why based on the type of flat file, we are creating a control file. That's why first we are learning how many types of flat files are available. At least what is flat file?
Flat file means a structured file which contains number of records. Two types of flat files are available. One is variable record flat file. Another one is fixed record flat file.
So many pillows are also called as variable length record flat file. This one fixed length record flat file. What is variable length record flat file means? A flat file which having a delimiters, those type of flat files are called variable length record flat file.
Suppose here some numbers 101, comma ABC, comma 2000 like this. Again 102, comma XYZ. Again 3000 like this. Again 103, PQR. Again 5000 like this. Now here these are records. These records in between the fields, some delimiter is there. Delimiter means comma, special symbols, comma, dollar symbol, hash, like this only. These are called delimiters. Whenever a flat file having a records and also in between fields within a records, in between fields delimiters are there, those type of flat files are called variable length record flat files. Whenever we are using a resource is a variable length record flat file, we are creating a some separate control file. What is fixed length record flat file or fixed record flat file means? A flat file which does not have any delimiters, those type of flat files are called fixed length record flat files. Suppose for example in this case 101, any space is there, without space is there, anything also, ABC 2000 like this. Again 102 XYZ, again 3000 like this. Again 103 PQR 5000 like this one.
That's why a flat file which does not have delimiter in between the fields, that is called fixed length record flat file. A flat file which having delimiters, special symbols in between the fields, that is called variable record flat file. Whenever any type of flat file, either variable record, either fixed record flat file they are giving, now we are transferring the data from this flat file into Oracle database by using a SQL Loader tool. Now observe it, what happened? Whenever we are transferring the data from flat file into Oracle database by using SQL Loader tool, SQL Loader directly does not transfer the data into Oracle database. SQL Loader always executes control file. This file extension is .ctl. That file we are creating, then only we are submitting. How can I create? We are learning only. First observe it, what is going on. This is a flat file, for example, a file which having a records only flat file. Some records are available, either fixed length or variable length or anything. Here, this is Oracle database. For example, this is Oracle database. Here some tables are there, any tables. For example, some table. This is a flat file they are giving. This is a target Oracle database is there. Now I want to transfer data from this flat file into Oracle database by using a what? SQL loader tool. Whenever we are installing Oracle server, automatically so many exe files are available. One of the exe file sqlldr.exe, that is a SQL loader tool. sqlldr.exe. This is SQL loader tool, but unfortunately SQL loader directly not transfer data from flat file into Oracle database. SQL loader always executes control file. That's why I am a programmer, we are a programmers. Based on the type of flat file, variable record or fixed length, based on the type of flat file, first we are creating a control file. That control file, because SQL loader always executes control file, this control file we are submitting into our SQL loader tool. Then only SQL loader transfer data from flat file into Oracle database. That's why first we are creating a what? Control file based on the type of flat file. Okay, control file we are creating. Control file we are creating only. How can I create means we are learning. .ctl is extension. That control file we are submitting by using a some syntax is there. I am submitting a what? This control file into SQL loader tool. Then only the SQL loader always transfer data from flat file into Oracle database. How it is possible? Within the control file, where the flat file is available, where the Oracle database is available, all the details are available in this file. Now here, whenever we are submitting a control file, then only SQL loader transfer data from this flat file into Oracle database. During this process automatically some other files also created. What is that file is created means practically we are learning, but before that one, whenever it will be transferred the data from flat file into Oracle database, automatically some file is created. This file is called log file. This file is called log file. This file extension is .log. This log file daily we are referring only. Why? Because in a project site, what are the errors are occurred in during this process, how many number of records are loaded, how many number of records are rejected, Oracle error numbers and error messages, these all the details are available in a log file. This log file stores all other files information and also loaded and rejected and skipped number of records, and also Oracle error numbers and error messages also it will be storing. Not only this file, based on some reasons in this process some records are rejected, some records are not stored properly into Oracle database, some records are rejected. Those rejected records are stored in two types of files are there. One is bad file. This is a bad file only. Bad file. This file extension is .bad. Again, another type of file is there. This file also stores rejected records. This file is a discard file. This file is a discard file. This file extension is .dsc. What is discard file? What is bad file? Practically we are learning. This bad file stores rejected records and a discard file also stores rejected records, but difference is there. Whenever problem is occurred either in a flat file or in a Oracle database, then only those rejected records are stored in a where? Bad file. Whereas in a discard file, here within a control file, we are writing a coding in a when class, when condition is there. Based on that when condition, some records are rejected. Those rejected records are stored in a discard file. That is, in a bad file means here data type mismatches are there. Again, business rule violations are there in a database. Based on that one only, some records are rejected. Those records are stored in a bad file. Again, when conditions programmatically also, we are transferring the data within a control file only. Some programs we are writing only. There is a when conditions we are writing. Based on that condition, not records are automatically stored in a discard file. This is a way we are transferring the data, and during that process some files also created. Now, how can I submit this control file into SQL loader tool? Some syntax is there. Through that syntax we are submitting into SQL loader tool, then only data is transferred. What is the syntax? How we are submitting a SQL loader, how we are submitting a control file into SQL loader tool? Observe it. Go to command prompt only, either C colon, D colon, where your vocational file is available. In that one, we are typing SQL LDR. SQL LDR is a exe file is there, that we are typing. Space user ID is equal to, here we are specifying which user your tables are available, target table, that is a username and password. Then only we are pressing a enter key. Whenever we are pressing a enter key, automatically control is equal to automatically displayed a message like this. In this here only, in a control is equal to all here only, whatever control file is there, we are creating that path of the control file we are using. This is the way we are submitting. Path of the control file. Path of the control file. Whenever we are submitting this control file by using this syntax, SQL loader syntax, then only data is transferred from flat file into Oracle database. Now, how can I write a control file? Now we are learning all. Generally, SQL loader tool directly does not transfer flat file data into Oracle database. SQL loader tool always executes control file. That file extension is .ctl. That's why first we are creating a control file and submit that control file into SQL loader tool. Then only SQL loader transfer data from flat file into Oracle database. Already have an idea, two types of flat files are there. One is variable record flat file, another one is fixed record flat file. Based on type of flat file, we are creating a control file and submit that control file into SQL loader tool. Today, we are creating a control file for variable length record flat file. Suppose here creating, how can I create a control file? I am telling creating a control file for variable record flat file. How can I create a control file for variable record flat file? Some steps are there. Through those steps only we are creating a control file. Actually, always control file execution start with some class only. What is that class? Load data is a class. Control file execution start with load space data is a class, because through the SQL loader we are loading a data. That's why they are providing load data class. After load data class, we must specify path of the flat file. By using a infile is a class is there, a separate class. Through that one, we are specifying a path of the flat file. Here we are specifying path where the location your flat file is available. Path of flat file we are specifying. After that one, we must load the data into Oracle database in a particular table by specifying a special class only. What is that class? Into table. Table name is a class is there. By using into table table name class, we are allowed to store that flat file data into Oracle database. But above into table table name class, we are using some clauses. Again, below into table table name class, we are allowed to use some clauses. In above into table table name class, we are using either insert or append or truncate or replace clauses. Based on the target table, whatever Oracle table is there, already Oracle table is empty table, then we are specifying a insert class. Already data is available, then we are appending a what data for the existing data, then we are using append class. That's why based on the type of data, based on the kind of table, we are specifying a insert, update, append, truncate and replace clauses. If empty table means we are using insert is a class. After into table table name class, we are specifying based on the flat file data, some type of data is there in a flat file, some special clauses we are using only. What is those clauses means? Fields, terminated by, here a predefined clauses, which delimiter is available in between the fields, those delimiters we are specifying a what? Fields terminated by class. Here delimiter name, practically we are learning these things. Again another class, a special class, optionally enclosed by, here delimiter name. Again a special clause is there, trailing null cols is a class. After these clauses, last only we are specifying whatever Oracle table columns are there, those column names, column 1, column 2, column 3, like this only, number of columns we are specifying. This is the way we are creating a what? Control file, and save this control file by using a .ctl extension, and then submit this control file, and then submit this control file by using, so now here following syntax, already we have an idea, this syntax. What is that one means? SQL LDR space user ID is equal to username, which user you are allowed to load the data, username and password. Press enter key means automatically displayed control. In this control only, we must specify path of the control file. Path of control file. Now, how we are transferring a data from flat file into Oracle database? By using a control file, one program I am writing means, then you are understandable. Now observe it here. I am taking a one flat file, in a flat file, in a C colon, D colon, anywhere also. I am creating a one flat file. Here some data I am taking. This is variable length record flat file 101, comma delimiter I am using ABC, again 2000, 102, XYZ, 3000, 103, in a data PQR, again 4000. This is a simple flat file. This flat file having a three records. And also in between the fields, comma delimiter is there. That's why any delimiter is available in a flat file. That is a variable length record flat file. I am saving this one, save as. This file, I try to save file 1 dot txt. This is a text file. I am specifying, I am saving I want this file. This file path we are using in your control file. Now I try to create a table in my database, Oracle database, SQL plus tool. Here within the Scott user, we are creating a table. Create table, table name, target, in a table name. In this table, those three fields I want to store it into this table columns.
That's why I'm specifying any columns. First column is our first field is number. That's why employee number I'm taking. Again, second column is names only. That's why I'm specifying e name, any name also. Here salary is a columns. I'm taking three columns. Now this is a target table. In this target table, we are allowed to store that flat file data. How can I store? SQL loader tool we are using. Where is that SQL loader? I'm opening SQL loader tool. Here command prompt. Here like this. SQL LDR. We are typing SQL LDR space user ID is equal to which schema we are inserting. Scott user only, my table is available. Press enter key. Here it will display control is equal to, because always SQL loader executes control file. That control file we are submitting to here only, then only data is transferred. That's why we are creating control file. Now here I try to create a small control file, new a text document like this. I'm creating a control file. Always control file execution start with load data is a class. After that one, we are specifying path of the control file by using infile class. Whatever path is there is flat file path. That file we have to specify file1.txt like this only. Now here my table is a target table, is an empty table. That's why we are specifying insert is a class. Then I want to load data means we are using into table, table name class. Target is a table. Here my flat file fields are separated with comma delimiter first initial stage. That's why we are using predefined class fields terminated, terminated by which delimiter is there, comma delimiter, by using this one. Again, whatever target table columns are there, those columns, employee number, comma e name, comma salary. Now this file, we must save this file by using .ctl extension. Otherwise it won't work. File, save, save as. Here I try to save this one, file name .ctl. I'm using Murli .ctl and also convert into all files. Now here save this one. Whenever we are saving this one, automatically the control file is created. In this format only control file is created. Now this control file I am submitting to where? SQL loader tool. How can I? We are opening SQL loader tool. In this tool, path of the control file we are specifying C colon here like this. Whatever control file name is there, Murli dot CTL like this. Now submitting control file. Whenever we are submitting this control file, automatically commit point reached, it will be displayed. That is successful execution. Once it will be transferred, we are submitting this control file, then we are checking really the flat file data is transferred into Oracle database or not. Now how can I check? Now here select star from table name target like this. Select star from table, what the table is there, target is a table. That table we are typing like this, then automatically this data is transferred. This is the way flat file data, very easy way we are transferring data into where? Oracle database by using SQL loader tool. Now what I am telling previous case, whenever we are transferring data from flat file into Oracle database, during that process
automatically some file is created, that is log file. That log file name is also same as control file name. Really, that log file is automatically created or not, we are checking. Now here, observe it here. This is a murli.ctl, okay, control file. The same file name automatically created is a log file name. Murli is also automatically created a log file. This log file daily we are referring, whatever errors are there, how many records are transferred, what type of files are available, these all the information is available in aware, this log file. Now I am opening this log file, then automatically this will shows all other files information and also stores here how many records are successfully transferred, 3 rows successfully loaded, these details are available, and also some records are not loaded, that we are learning later only, those all the details are here, bad file, discard file, these all the details here only it will be displayed. This is the way we are transferring the data from flat file into Oracle database. Now I want to open this control file, just we are opening like this. I want to view this file, go to notepad, double click like this, automatically this control file is available. Not only particular location in a flat file, but that flat file data we can also specify within a control file itself, possible actually less than 100, less than occasion of your 50, these type of number of records are very less, in that case we can also transfer data directly by specifying what flat file data within control file itself. Can we transfer the data other than particular location? The data is available in a particular flat file, possible? Possible. How can I mean? Observe it here. Suppose this is a flat file data is there. Now this data, suppose one or two records I am copying. This is another alternative way also we are transferring the data. Now here this data I am specifying here within control file, and bottom of the control file I am specifying this data. We can also transfer data from the SQL loader tool by specifying that data within a control file itself, possible. Just I am specifying last of the control file, that those records only, and after that one, once we are specifying these records, just don't use any path of the flat file. In place of path of the flat file, we must specify star. Here we are using what? Star only, asterisk we are using. And also we must use another class in the above of the flat file data. We must specify begin data is a class. These are the two classes we are using. One is begin data we must specify in the above of the flat file data, and also we must specify star in place of path of the flat file. Then already the data is there. I am changing this insert into append like this. Now these records also, these two records also allowed to store it into flat file on Oracle database or not, we are checking. Suppose here this is a murli.ctl. Now here I am changing this one into all files, save this one, okay. Again I try to execute, that extra two records are appended or not, we are checking. Now here this is the way, here control file I am submitting, any errors are there it will display it, but unfortunately here commit point reached only, I am submitting like this. Now again that data also storing or not, we are checking. This is a database, within a database we are observing, yes, extra two records are, these two records are appended into existing table. That's why this is the way we can transfer data from flat file into a Oracle database by using SQL loader tool. Two ways, one is the flat file data is available in a particular location, C colon D colon in Windows like this. Otherwise, that flat file data directly available in our control file itself. In this case also, by using a star in place of path of the flat file within infile class, and also we must use begin data class in the above of the flat file data. Through that one also we can transfer the data. Then next class we are learning bad file, control file. So many classes are there. Through that one, how can I transfer the data?